time, even as we acknowledge the presence of the Holy Ghost, He is here with us. You see, He tells us that where two or three are gathered in Jesus' name, Jesus is there with us. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. There's a confidence. You see, it's amazing. We don't just need to have that confidence only. There's also yet another confidence that we should have. See, the Bible tells us that He's an omnipresent God.
Yes.
Amen. He's an omnipresent God. In other words, if He wasn't here, He would not have been there.
Amen.
Amen. If He wasn't here, He would not have been there. In other words, where He is does not exist. Mm. Amen. You can't pinpoint a place and say, God is not there. Mm. Amen. So what the worst of place you can think about, God is there.
Amen.
No wonder why we hear King David talking about, even if I descend into the depth of hell, He is there.
Yes.
Now, if I lay, I don't know who would want to lay a bed in hell, but King David says, even if I lay my bed in hell, He is there.
Amen.
Amen. So you just need to have this confidence that God is there.
Amen.
Amen. So I think the only thing that needs to happen is our senses that need to be awakened in order for us to experience this God.
Amen.
Amen. It's us who need to be awakened in order for us to experience Him, because He is there.
Hallelujah.
He's there.
Amen.
So in that house, when you're all by yourself and you feel like there are demons in the ceiling, I mean, I've always heard, Apostle Charles preaching, and he'll say, people would call him and say, the demons are in my ceiling. Men of God, please pray for me, or men of God, come to my house. That moment you feel like demons are in your ceiling, I need you to know that God is in that house.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The only thing that needs to happen is that you need to be awakened. You need to, you see, you're too sensitive to demonic spirits, but you're so not sensitive to the Spirit of God, which is actually there. Amen.
Amen.
The Spirit of God is there.
Amen. Yes.
See, even earlier as I was talking, giving a testimony, I was talking about how the peace of God that passes all understanding kept me in 2017. Amen. Kept me in 2017. Why? Because God was with me.
Oh yes.
Amen. God was with me, and He continues to be with me.
Amen.
Amen. Which simply means that the moment God stops being with me, I stop being in existence.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen.
The moment He stops being with me, I stop being in existence. Mm. Amen. So we bless the name of God for His presence, for we know that He's here with us. Mm. Amen. He's
Amen.
Here with us. Amen. If you came to this place and you were sick, I need you to understand that darkness and light cannot dwell in the same place.
Mm.
Amen. In other words, sickness is darkness and health is light. So therefore, you got to receive your healing this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Mm. You got to receive your healing this morning in the name of Jesus.
Praise
because
the Lord.
God is in this place.
Hallelujah.
Amen. No wonder why you hear King David. No wonder why you hear King David say, "I was glad when they said, 'Let us go to the house of the Lord.'"
Amen.
See, I don't know what he was going through. I don't know what situation was in his life. Mm. Amen. I don't know what was happening to him, but somebody said, "Let us go to the house of the Lord," and he was glad.
Amen.
Amen. He could have been sick. Mm. I don't know what situation he was in, but then when he heard that we are supposed to go to the house of the Lord, there was gladness that was ignited on
Amen.
The inside of him. Amen.
Amen.
So I need somebody to just have this confidence that your life will never be the same.
Amen.
Your life will never be the same.
Amen.
Praise God. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Wow, wow, wow. Let me get into my message of the day. Amen.
Amen.
You see, we all understand that tomorrow is Christmas Day. Amen.
Amen.
And it so happens that we chose that particular day, I don't know who did, but many years ago, more than 2,000 years ago, it was selected that it was on that particular day we would celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
One thing that we need to understand is it's not important when He was born. Amen.
Amen.
But it is important that He was born. Amen. And if there's any question that you should ask is why was He born? Amen. So in other words, the question of when He was born does not matter. But the question of why He was born is the most important question. Amen.
Amen.
Because what happened is that people would get into a lot of theological, theological arguments of the birth of Jesus. Somebody said, oh no, He must have been born in October. Tell me, oh, He must have been born in this particular month. It's not important when He was born. Amen.
Amen.
What's important is why was He born? Amen.
Amen.
Why was Jesus born?
Amen.
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 I mean, living in Zimbabwe, you would know that at some point we were in a colonial era.
Mm.
And there's a very much possibility that your grandparents, if you were to ask them their date of birth, they probably don't even know. They probably don't even know. But they have a national ID, and that national ID has a birth on it. Amen. And we celebrate the date of birth on their national ID. Amen. Not necessarily because that is the day they were born. Amen. So in other words, this question of saying when was Jesus born is not important. But the fact that they celebrate his birth is important. Amen.
Praise
God. Amen.
Amen.
So now zeroing in on why was Jesus born. In order for us to understand the reason why Jesus was born, we need to go back to the account of creation. Amen.
Amen.
When you go back to the book of Genesis, the only way we can understand the reason why Jesus was born is when we go back to the book of Genesis. So if we're to open our Bibles in the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 26 and 27, the Bible reads and tells us, you see, this is what God says in that portion of scripture. God tells us, God says, let us make man in our own image, after our own likeness. Amen. And then it goes on to say, let them have dominion. Amen.
Amen.
Let them have dominion over the fowl of the earth, the beast of the earth, and the fish of the sea.
Amen.
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 That was God's original intent as far as man was concerned.
Amen.
God wanted man to have dominion on planet earth. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible goes on to tell us that God created man. In that particular portion of scripture, in the 27th verse, it tells us that male and female. And when you continue reading the scriptures, when you then get to the second chapter there, the 7th verse, the Bible tells us that, and then God formed. Actually, it's interesting because in verse 1, God actually creates man, but in verse 2, God forms man. It's quite interesting.